Serves it into the forehand, the pendulum serve, and Calderano is always really low, just peeking over the table, tries to get his backhand flick, but to no avail. Levels it up here, the third from Brazil. Another very high toss server. Catches Tagami out there. In the rally, barely anyone can compete with the brutality of Calderano. He's just so powerful. And that's saying something because of how well Tagami meets the ball as well. Calderano's going to have to receive well this match. That for me is the key to beating Tagami, because in the rally, Calderano's good, but he's got to remain disciplined, not drift back too much. Mid-distance is fine, but he doesn't want to give Tagami that too many times. Although there, look about that for some cash back. Just slaps it. Again, how entertaining this man can be. We get to see it so soon. Oh, as well as this. He missed out on the World Team Champs in Busan, which was quite a questionable move for many. Returned into action at the Smash and lost in the round of 64 there to Cho Dae-song, Calderano. Got it! Looking to get back to his best in many ways. Wouldn't say he's any worse than what he was a couple of years ago, Calderano, but there's a few more names now that you can call Olympic medal challengers. Tagami there. Gets a dribbler. Gets a net. He's one of them, Tagami. And the Japanese men's team is very young, but they're just going through this kind of transitional phase right now. Sora Matsushima could be the one to join Haramoto in singles, but still some time. That's the threat there. Right over. Physicality. You don't notice the weight transfer of a backhand as much, because you can't have that, but there still is some. We hear from Calderano for the first time this match. Happy with that one. That's amazing. How he picks up the half long and how quickly he gets to a neutral point. Just snaps at this backhand. Tagami's going to have to chase again. It's a great serve. Stamps his foot to try and mask the indication of spin, and can be quite distracting. But it was the same service toss, different contact, and it ruffled the feathers of Calderano. Who manages, though, to keep his nose in front. They both kind of need a little bit of each other's game. Tagami needs some of Ugo's dynamic diversity. Calderano needs that discipline in terms of how he maintains similar distance from the table. What a counter, the angle. Both manage to maneuver each other wide. What about that? Poetry in motion from Calderano. Gasps from the crowd. They didn't know you could hit a ball that hard. They do now. It's a reality check here for Tagami. Staring down the barrel of a gun. Oh, blinking, you miss him. Can you make history here in Incheon?
Got it! What? Got it!
Tried to finish it there, kill it. Tried to play the backhand from the forehand. Into the middle. Well done. Tagami knows if a ball is just a little bit loose, it's going to be very, very tough to deny Calderano the point. But he's not one to lay down, Tagami. He likes to match fire with fire. Obviously believes he can out-hit Calderano. Look, he's done it twice before in three meetings. We've seen videos all over the internet, viral moments of Calderano coming up with just magic away from the table. Did it in the first game with that slap. Can't land the backhand that time. Trailing by three.
Whoa!
Yeah, looking at the head-to-head. The last time they played, Calderano did win. The star contender Ljubljana quarter final. It's 11-6 in game five. Calderano nearly beat Fan Jindong the round after. But at that event, Tagami beat Tomokazu Haramoto. Two times before that, Tagami won 3-1 at their first meeting at the World Champs in Chengdu and then at the contender Zagreb. 3-2. So we've never seen a clean sweeper between these two men. And Tagami making sure that doesn't happen here. 6-1 up in the second. Got him out of position, wrong-footed him with that receive there, Tagami. Lovely stuff. Not easy to dig long in that way. It requires wrist to get it deep, but that can be the thing that sends it too long. Cracker. Smacks it. You can hear the sound. How driven the shots are of Calderano. One of the most athletic players on tour. I'd say Tagami's on the list too. This is relentless. Spraying it around here. Wouldn't be a shocking time to call a timeout. After this towel break.
5-7.
Looks like Tagami's going to try and save it for later if he needs to. Maybe he'd call it if Calderano won this point. Let's see. I don't know what he apologises for, as it hit the top edge. Calderano's bat. That's where you get prize money and ranking points just for getting here, being eligible. Showcasing his skills here, Calderano. Timeout diffused. 6 of the last 8 to the Brazilian. Tried to float it, but Tagami really clear-minded in terms of what he wanted to do there. There's the footwork, how he just shimmies across, the speed of that. Just as impressive as the shot, maybe even more impressive. Catches the net. So much arc on these balls. Oh, but that really mucked it up for Tagami. Threw off his anticipation. And the serves with Calderano. Could he go 2-0 up the Brazilian? This could be a make it or break it moment for the Japanese. Nicely done. The little mini forehand flick of Calderano would have fooled many, but not Tagami. Does well there not to go too big on that shot. It's nice rotation, good wrist work, gauges the percentage as well. And wins both against serve. Now having 2 of his own. Great fortitude from Shinsuke Tagami. Just glances it there, a faded guide flick. Something different. Could hear a pin drop in the Infinity Arena. Get into the eyes of his opponent, Tagami, with another game point. Shit! Oh, that was wicked from Calderano. In a defensive position, but still plays aggressive shots. Such a freestyle he has. Seems to do what he wants at times. Doesn't even have to kind of live within the realm of the tactical world. Juice. Go! Oh! Skidded along there. Tagami with a 3rd game point. Got to take this, hasn't he? Adjust his position. Calderano with a dainty little touch. Denies him once more. Man, this would be a tough pill to swallow for Tagami. Had his chances. can't lob it down. Tightens the screw there, Tagami. Doesn't take his foot off Calderano's neck. And he gets that first forehand in right off the serve. Fourth game point. Can't take it. Had an eye to kill there. Wasn't too far off, but he knows he had the time to play it. Did he go maybe too wild? Tagami in the final of the contender Taiyuan, where he had match point on Liang Jingquin. Just went a little bit wild on the match point. It's a question of how he tames his aggressive instinct.
Whoa!
There, just took a little touch into the middle. I guess more of a push in length. What's this now, the fifth game point for Tagami? Remarkable, isn't it? An undying effort from Calderano. He is just refusing to give Tagami this game. He's not had a game point. Could this be the moment he gets one? Fans himself down. Here we go. Tagami tries to take on the flick from the forehand. Just got a bit stuck. Oh no. Japanese fans have their hearts in their mouths. It's a very good serve, and it's a very brave serve. You have to execute that spot on, and he did. There was the impending doom of the Calderano backhand waiting, but he didn't put it into the sweet spot. Not much between them in serve success, and nothing between them in the score. 14-0. Oh, that's emphatic from Tagami. He channeled his inner cocky Niwa there with a cavalier finish to a well-constructed point. Really nice control. There's nothing Calderano could do. Hand switch or double-handed backhand considered. And well, there's no cho. A new and youngest star present, and Tagami. Brilliant winner there from Hugo Calderano. Who is the only Brazilian here? We've got some other strong players like Eric Juti, Vitor Ishii, but he's their main man. Always sniffing Tagami, he's always hunting for something poachable. Lovely receive, the touch, chop block. Wow, the feeling from Calderano there. Turning topspin into straight backspin. Wow, that was beautiful. Seems to have just relaxed into it a bit more here. Playing on pure instinct. Looking at the draw, the winner of this will face the winner of Alexi Lebrun, who's up against Gao Zheng Rei. Two young players under the age of 21. So many mouthwaterers today. I think on the men's side, maybe the one that most people are looking out for is Charles Morrigard, who's facing Ma Long. That'll be their first singles international meeting. And a match that the ball boys and girls will be looking forward to as well. The ball kids are from the SIA Academy and are all aspiring table tennis players. The SIA group to nurture and grow the next generation of Korean talents. Could be seeing a future Lee Sang-soo, Im Jong-hoon, Jung-woo Jin. In these young ball kids. Oh my word. Whoa! That is absolutely stupendous. Kind of rallies that make you fall in love with table tennis. Quality on tap. And Tagami has just harnessed something pretty good there. God knows how that backhand of Calderano came back. It came out of nowhere.
Go!
As things so often do. Too shallow and high there from Calderano. Made it quite easy for Tagami to come in. 4-5 in the third. We've seen that serve have some success, but not that time. Had it in the memory bank, Calderano. Wasn't going to be fooled by it again. Wow, it came back and Calderano tried to go down the line. Tried to switch Tagami around. But the response from the backhand of the Japanese was just about right. Very powerful. Connected with it really well. Did with the flick too, but Calderano booms it. Venomous shot. The variation of Calderano sometimes makes him end up in a defensive position. So if he's going to use some creativity, got to try and use it aggressively. Tagami's more of a root one player, as we said, less dynamic. You know what he's going to do? But he's so quick, it's difficult to do anything about. Calderano pounces there after the long push. Stunning step over. Exactly the kind of aggression that he needs to have. Tagami staying in the conversation. Players wiping their hands near the net because when they get sweaty, they need to get rid of the sweat. So they put it in the place where the ball is least likely to hit.
Line six.
Calderano living up to the expectation here. Looking to level the head-to-head against the man who denied him a fifth contender title. Is the joint second all-time leader, Calderano, in WTT event wins. Four contenders and a star contender that was back in 2021. Semi-finalist of two Singapore Smashers. Hasn't quite had the success at champions level. Maybe it could be different here in Incheon for the thrill from Brazil. Three game points here. Nice inside out forehand. That's what the best players are the best at. Making it seem simple. Making it feel easy to play. Table tennis, you want to have smooth shots. To get that consistency, control. You don't want to do too much in between them. And it all stems from the footwork. Tagami, along with Jang Woojin and Xu Yingbin, for me, some of the very, very best footwork in the game. But it's the wisdom that comes with experience. And Calderano is just showing just a little bit more composure. The intent there from Calderano. Tagami coils that wrist back, produces loads of rotation. Difficult to know when to meet the ball when it's spinning so much. That's one that he'd normally make. Tagami, two ahead here, but we see another match here, the second of the event. Go the distance. Shovel serve from Tagami. Not a good enough receive from Calderano. And he's punished for it. Upon it. Holds in there for that one. Look at these backhands. Took a bit of pace off the second one. Put it into the backhand side. Not the easiest way to win a point, but he'll take it. Better quality touch there. That's what he's really been working on.
Got it!
How deep was the push, but Tagami spin there. Awesome. You cannot push a ball any better than what Calderano did. Amazing answer there from the Japanese.
Ready, draw.
And you wonder now what will happen. No one's looked as though they're going to sail through.
Oh!
Wow. Whoa. Harnessing Calderano-like backhands there to Gami from further away. Change of pace didn't affect the Japanese player. He bombed it into the crossover of Calderano and will remain in front for now at least. Absolutely clattered it. Stand and deliver. Gami had a hint of admiration in his eyes there. Got it, taken a lot here, but he's managed to level. Bit of respite for Calderano. Pressure on Santuki Tagami to convert behind his two serves in this must-win game. Clever service change. Shovel again, but wider into backhand. The kind of serve that makes it very hard to power flick. Big point here. But really well blocked. Absorbs it. Keeps the bat high. Racket closed. Counteract all that topspin Calderano had generated from the middle with his backhand. This has been just cat and mouse. Just chained together, these two. Is it destined to go the distance?
Oh!
Brilliant. Oh! I've been amazed with some of Tagami's reactions to these surprising pushes. Again, it's his footwork. How he manages to get behind the ball. In a way that he wants. Two game points to Shunsuke Tagami of Japan. And he manages to get back the big bomber backhand of Calderano. Can he come back stronger? See how much just winning that first point alone meant to him. This could be a dogfight.
Oh.
Too good from Tagami. They're both so powerful. The prowess in the attacking game is something that the other has really struggled to deal with, and that's why we're seeing the score like it is. Oh, spanks it, Tagami. Go sit on the naughty step, he says. The speed. My God. 6 of the last 8. To Shunsuke. Shovel, but can't meet the ball as he wants with his third ball forehand flick. Just denied by the tape there. You know, to get it past Calderani, you've got to play with power, but again, did he rush a bit to Tagami? Tagami, one behind in this deciding game. Nicely done there from Calderano. He comes across it more, which confuses Tagami a bit. He was there to block it, but nice disguise. Straight backspin serve. Just bites into the table surface. Another change of ends. Calderano, 3 ahead. Almost unreplicable, the power that the third from Brazil gets. One of the most feared shots in the game. Wins that exchange. See the use of his legs, Tagami, how he transfers his weight. So seamless. This flick right here, more powerful than most players' smashes. Barely even needs a backswing on it. Acceleration, just a blur. Well, he's in exactly the right position to finish this, Calderano, but he cannot afford to ease off. 8-3 to the world number 8. What a finish. 2 away from sailing through to the round of 16. Could have been flashbacks to the smash, as well as some of the tough moments. But Calderano has done very, very well here in the fifth. Epic. It's 7 game and 7 match points to the thrill from Brazil. The Chiquita does it. He sees off Shunsuke Tagami and levels the head-to-head overall between them.